Not again.
Oi, get off! Hey, that's mine! Oi, ow! Give me back my umbrella!
Vermin! You're vermin, you are! Get off! Lipping delinquents. That's the third time this week. And thanks for your help, by the way. What on earth are you doing?
Forget the pigeons, Rex. We've got serious problems.
Take a look in there.
Honestly, you're not telling me that you're scared of that little...
Danger! Danger!
You don't understand, Rex.
Danger!
He gave Bob a Chinese burn, didn't he, Bob?
Yes, he did.
Said he's a friend of yours.
Really? No, never seen him before in my life. Oi, you! There's nothing for you here.
Hello, Rex.
Now look, I said there was nothing for you here, and I meant it.
Well, that's not very friendly, is it, Rex?
Come on, hop it. You'll just have to take your chances with the pigeons outside.
I wouldn't get too close, Rex. He did that to Bob as well, didn't he, Bob?
Yes, he did.
Did he? Did he really? Hello, I think I'm infested. And welcome to my Rex.
Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, it's time for a doggy dialogue. Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, a wobbly bobbly trilly squiggly dog.
Sorry, Rex. Should have stopped you, I suppose.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks a lot. Vince, you can stop fanning me now, thank you. I'm not unconscious anymore. How are we going to get rid of the damn thing?
Mouse! Bastard! Kill! Kill!
Yeah, right, Vince, right. Why don't you go and sort him out?
Catchy mouse.
Oh, don't he look cute? Go on, Bennett.
Don't do it, Vince.
Don't leave bother. It.
You're having a laugh.
Nice try.
Look, Vince, I wouldn't bother.
Leave it, Vince. He's too strong.
Hatchy plan.
Bob, why didn't you scare him off with your gun?
Tried that.
What about the other gun?
Swapped it last week for a harmonica. I tried doing this. But the mouse just danced.
Look, shoo, will ya? Go and bother someone else. Oh, I can't believe this. Delinquent pigeons outside and an aggressive rodent in the kitchen. It's like we're not in control of our own lives.
I know. I'll phone Tiddles.
Not Tiddles the destroyer. No, let's talk about this, shall we, eh?
Hello?
Hello, is that Tiddles?
Speaking.
Oh, hello, I don't know if you remember me. Wendy, we used to be at school together.
Wendy? Yeah, I remember you all right. We used to call you Wendy the...
You still in the boxing game, Tiddles?
No, I gave up that yonks ago, Wendy. Still train, though.
Listen, I was wondering...
Hang on a minute. Do you still see that fat dog with the eye patch?
Bob, you mean Bob?
I swear if I ever catch up with that Bob again, I'm going to give him a real good spanking.
I think we all would, Tiddles, if we knew where he was. No one set eyes on him for years. Anyway, I've got a favour to ask. I was wondering if you could come over.
Right. Revenge.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Oi, what's the matter? Oi, oi, what's your game? Do you want to have a Chinese bird?
No, please, Mr. Mouse. I just wanted a little snack.
What you got there, then?
Aqua, concentrated recovered meat extract flavour, horse balls, sugar, marrow,
sounds disgusting.
Rust and monosodium scrotumate.
All right. Oh, go on, take it.
Oh, you are so kind. Thank you. Bye for now. Bye.
Mission accomplished.
What? He's gone?
No, but I've got some food.
Thank you. He'll never get past those pigeons.
Hello, Tiddles. It's good to see you haven't lost your touch.
Never leaves you, Rex. Never leaves you. Hello, Wendy. Long time no see.
Thanks for coming, Tiddles.
You know, you look familiar.
Oh, this is Malcolm, Tiddles. He's Welsh.
Oh, so he is.
And this is the mouse I was telling you about.
All right. Oh, yeah. Is that the time? I really should be off, you know. Bye, Wendy. Bye, Rex. Bye, Malcolm.
Bye. Here, you dropped this.
Come any time, Tiddles.
Nice to have met you, my wee bunny Tiddles.
It's magic.
What is it you want? Money? Food? Wendy?
Rex?
We'll give you anything if only your shoe. Please. Ever so please, shoe.
You don't remember me, do you, Rex?
What do you mean, remember you?
You don't recognise me at all. What about now?
It's Morris, your old one-gloved mouse.
Oh, so it is. Who'd have thought it?
Don't you remember, Rex? I used to be your pride and joy. He used to take me everywhere, told me he loved me. Then one day, just gets bored, sells me to Dr. Dog for animal experimentation. First, it was all right. Plenty of girls around and all the fags you could smoke. Why else do you think I sound like this? Then they turns nasty. Shampooing me eyes and all sorts of stuff up me bum. Very undignified. Now, even they don't want me. I'm so used to all the rubbish they pumped into my tiny frame. No good for testing anymore. All I want is a place for my twilight years. I still love you, Rex. Despite the pain.
I love you too, Wandlove Morris. This is your home. For the rest of your life. However long that may be.
Not long, Rex. Not long.
Finch, you idiot. You've just killed the only mouse Rex ever loved.
Oh, pancakes.
Hang about. That's not one gloved Morris. He always wore his glove on his left hand. This is just some freeloading rodent imposter.
Ooh.
His death doesn't call for tears, but for celebration.
Hey! Yeah.
I suppose this is what they consider a happy ending.
What's going on? Oi! Shoo!
What do they want?
I think it's me.
Hey?
What do you mean?
It's me. I'm on heat.
No. That's all we need.
It's a perfectly natural bodily function, you know.
I know. It's
just... only once every 6 months.
Come on, old girl. Better get you inside.
Get your hands off me! And not so much of the old gal, if you don't mind.
All right, all right.
Blimey. Hello, I'm Rex, and welcome to my hormonal world.
I heard that.
Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, it's time for a doggy dialogue. Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, a wobbly, bobbly, dribbly, squiggly dog.
Don't worry, Wend. We'll look after you.
Maybe I don't need looking after Bob. Get that, will you, Rex?
All right, all right.
Wendy, hi.
Baby, you're looking so hot tonight. Ooh.
Upon the dazzling lawn of summer, stands the shrubbery of my love. That really hurts.
Well, the thing is, I was wondering whether if there
what
was
do
any
you
chance.
Want?
Well, what I mean to say is,
no,
can I possibly? I wondered if I might be so bold as to,
Hang on, Rex. You were quite nice.
What? Him?
I wondered if I might be so
bold as to... I haven't seen him before. Wow, nice board.
Wondered if I might be so bold as to ask if you're free 7:30 Saturday.
I might be. Anyway, what's your name, saucy paws?
It's Rex.
Eh?
Hello, Rex. Nice to meet you. 7:30 it is then.
Hey, hang on. You can't be called Rex as well.
Why not?
Well, it'll confuse people.
I don't think so somehow.
Ciao.
I really don't see why I shouldn't go on my own.
I insist on being your chaperone.
No way, not after what happened last time.
Keep
your hands on the table where I can see them.
Look, I still think someone should go along with you, Wendy. It's only because we care. I'd be inconspicuous. Hey, I'm Fido. Of course, they all know me in here.
Showing us up.
So tell me, Wendy, what takes your fancy?
Well, if you can't have anything too rich, make some videos.
Rex, please. Well, Rex, it all looks very nice to me. You choose me something.
She can't read French, you see.
Please excuse me a moment, Rex. Rex, can I have a word?
Gosh.
Sorry about that, Rex. Now, where was we?
Yes, that seems to have dislodged it. Thank you.
Oh. Hello, Arthur.
Good evening, Bob, sir. I was wondering if Miss Wendy was about.
I'm afraid she's out, Arthur.
Out, eh? Oh, good-looking bloke, is he?
Oh, yes. Nice car and all.
Oh.
Listen, Arthur, maybe Wendy would take you more seriously if you smartened yourself up a bit.
You reckon? Yeah. Oh, sorry about the smell. Yeah. Just finished me shift.
Look, why don't you go and have a bath?
Oh, thank you very much, Bob. You're a gent. On the understanding, I don't do no nude scenes.
No chance.
Oh.
And then there's that one that goes, no, 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 there's no limit. Very uplifting, that one. Little Pork Pie by Johnny Savoy.
Trousers.
Lloyd McCole and the Motions. He were gorgeous.
Arthur, pass me your clothes and I'll run them through the machine.
Why, thank you, Bob. Here you go. Pants, cap and a neckerchief.
Proportion of boiled money, making the resultant company very highly geared.
I wonder if that's a toupee. And hang on a minute, it's coming to a close.
Short-term profitability to meet the interest charges.
Interest charges. Interesting. Have you heard that one, horny, horny?
Horny?
I like that.
Oh, thank you.
What a transformation.
Slight discomfort around the unmentionables, but I'm sure they'll stretch.
Right. Nasal hair.
Gulp.
Jam.
Ow!
Oh, I'd say that my favourite type of jam is almost certainly strawberry.
Oh, strawberry, right. So what's your second favourite type of jam?
Well, I think it would have to be...
No, I know what you're going to say. Look, sorry, guys. Me and Vince should leave you two alone.
No,
Rex,
No,
don't thank me. Seeing you happy is thanks enough. Come on, Vince. There's a Rocket Raymond film on later.
Yes, Attack of the Space Rodents. I was hoping to catch it.
What, you're a fan?
Yes, indeed.
Rocket Raymond at your service. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da! Look out, evil. I'm on your tail. Waiter, another bottle of wine over here.
Oh, blooming flipping neck.
Oh, Bob, sir, with the greatest respect, I think this is going too far.
Eh?
You see, I think that my nostril hairs are part of my grubby, roguish charm. They reflect my laissez-faire attitude to my grooming, suggesting that I am someone who is not vain. Girls love it, you know.
No, they don't.
Ah, oh.
the director's wife. I didn't even know there was one.
I met Julian Lilyhampton once at a party a few years ago.
The friendly alien?
Ha-ha! Evil has been crushed and now I will crush your head!
Flippin' Nora. Oi, Garson, could I have the bill, please?
I've got the talking rocket, Raymond, still in its original box.
Come on, Rex.
Right. Of course, there are loads of Raymond websites.
That's it. I've had enough. See you later, Rex. Goodbye forever, Rex. Come on, Vince.
Yeah.
See ya.
Pompous twit.
Of course, some of them are total rubbish. Jetpackattack.com's the worst. Full of mistakes. And as for the spelling...
Thanks. That's my website.
Oh, I didn't mean...
You're not the one mailing me with spelling corrections, are you?
I might have done a couple of times.
Oh, really?
No offence, but there were a few factual errors. I mean, everyone knows it was all shot in Barnsley.
Stand here. No, here. That way, when Wendy comes through the door there, she'll see you in your best light.
Bob, I don't know how to thank you. You're a diamond geezer.
That's it. Right, good luck.
It's been meat grating you, Rex. Not often one bumps into a Rocket Raymond fan. Maybe we could do this again sometime.
Yeah, you could. Pretty busy at the moment. I'll give you a call sometime, OK?
OK. And remember, I... Da-da-da-da-da-da!
Men, if they're not pawing you all over, they're boring you rigid talking rubbish all night. I hope I never see another one as long as I... Oh, Arthur, how could I have overlooked you all this time? The way your nose hairs catch the light, accentuating your grubby, roguish charm and laissez-faire attitude to grooming. You make me feel so... Nothing at all, actually. Well, that's it for another 6 months.
It's been over a week. Why hasn't he called? We had so much in common. Does my breath smell or something?
Yes.
Like a fish in a cheese purse.
Forget it, Rex. Here, have some more ice cream. Remember, we've always got each other.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Pass the sick bag, man.
Hello, I am an ant, and welcome to my
Hello, I'm Rex, and welcome to my new patio.
Well, that's two slabs down. I'll go put the kettle on.
Bob, come back here. We've hardly started, for goodness sake.
Oh.
It says here you're supposed to dig about a foot down and lay a 6-inch thick scrape followed by a float of sand and cement.
Nah. They're fine just going straight on the grass.
I still don't know why we had to have a patio. I like the grass. You like the grass as well, didn't you, Vince?
Shift your bum! Get off me, wife! Oh, you're asking for it!
Jesus!
Oh,
come on, my auntie!
Blimey, he's gone all random again.
I know! We could protest by digging a tunnel under the patio and then holding a sit-in! Flip me neck! We're ants! We dig tunnels all the time! No one will notice!
The time for ideas are over. Now it are time for action! We've suffered in silence long enough. From now on, those dogs will call fear by another name.
What will they call it exactly?
They will call it ants. Now, listen carefully.
It's not very straight. You should have done it by the book.
No, it'll be fine. Just needs a little... There, perfect. Now, I'm starving.
Rex, look!
Ow! No wonder they were so cheap.
Maybe we should have put that scree down. It did say they'd shift about a bit otherwise.
Shift about a bit? It landed on my foot! Well, I know my rights.
Here at Budget, we're slashing prices on all our most dangerous household items.
Like this unpredictable cordless power fork, reduced from $49.99 to $48.59. Yes, $48.59.
Or this retractable wobbly saw.
All right, who's in charge of paving slabs
here? Ideal for cutting things.
Oi.
But it's not just our life-threatening items that we're cutting prices on.
Move by themselves?
Yes, that's what I just said.
We're cutting the cost on boring stuff too.
Don't come in with me, sonny.
Like taps, Oi. Insulating foam, bricks.
And wood, Babney. So, come on down to Bodget. There's a whole lot waiting in store for you.
You can't do this to me!
Look, stay where I put you. Oi!
Maybe, Bob. Maybe we've got a poltergeist, Bob. Bob, we could get it circumcised.
Exorcised.
Right, says here you've gone funny in the head.
Ooh.
Seen moving paving slabs, have we? You're mad.
No, I'm not.
Ah, says here that all mad people think they're not mad.
I'm not mad.
You are. You're just in denial.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I am not in denial. I am not in denial.
Ah, good book, this. Right, I'm going to show you a random ink blot. Tell me what it reminds you of.
Ah, a paving slab.
No problem. I shift about half a dozen every week.
Well, get on with it then. Oi, Bob, come out from behind that bin and help us.
Let us join forces in love, brothers and sisters, to free this backyard of his demonic demons.
So, brothers and sisters, just like you, I have lived here all my life. Amongst the dandelion and fag end.
Be gone! Osvaldo Halitosis commands you, be gone! Leave this patio!
Are we gonna let him talk to us like that?
No!
Well, well worth a tenner that was.
It probably all started with my mother. I was the last of the litter.
Look, I have got other patients to see.
I could never live up to my older brother becoming a guide dog.
Gordon Bennett.
I suppose I'm seeking a surrogate family.
Go home!
What about some primal scream therapy? I've always fancied that.
Ah! Ah!
I know. Maybe I could express my anger through dance. Better already. Get off. I'm not leaving until I've been rebirthed. What about a spot of colonic irrigation?
Once more unto the breach, dear friends, once more. Oh, yes. Oh, close the wall up with our English dad.
Hey, Woodlouse fella, who are you calling English?
Throw your safety overboard and join our insect nation.
Don't overdo it, Neil.
Our homes, our families, our very lives have been in jeopardy for too long. Friends, it's time we showed them we mean business. Let's chuck their house over a cliff!
Yay! I'm letting you go. You are mad.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are, but I just don't care anymore. Tell me about your childhood again and I'll genetically modify your testicles.
They look all right to me. What do you think?
Tapestry, cyclone, special offer, laser and stone
really?
Roof tiles, super done with Osovich.
Blimey, it's contagious.
I knew I wasn't mad. Bob, have you upset our house in some way?
No, no, it just run off.
Run off? Follow that house!
After the next set of traffic lights!
Please, come back! Have we done something to hurt you?
Flippin' heck, it's gonna chuck itself off! I'm sure that's not covering the building's insurance.
Don't do it! Please! Look, whatever we've done to upset you, I'm sure we can work it out!
Come on, let's do it! After three. One.
Wait!
What?
After three, right?
That's what he said, isn't it? One. Two.
Wait!
What?
Just wait. I mean, maybe we're being a bit hasty. It's our house as well, after all. I mean, isn't there always sugar in the kitchen?
And jam?
And jam, yes, yes. And marmalade sometimes as well. And those biscuits with the chocolatey bits that we all like.
Oh, yeah, no, yeah, I agree. Oh, he's got a point.
Come on. What do you say? We...
We love you.
Okay, come on, let's take it back. I think we are made our point.
Yay!
It's slipping from my grasp. Well, that's knackered it. Right, I have a new idea.
That poor house. What could have made it do such a thing?
Maybe it was the Artex ceilings.
Hey?
Our house is back.
But it... we...
Welcome home, big fella.
So, our adventure was over. Our house that we'd seen jump off a cliff was back. But when we went to look in the garden, the patio that we'd so carefully laid had mysteriously disappeared. Talk about crazy paving.
Flipping heck, Rex. You said you wouldn't say that.
Trousers.
Right, come on everyone, let's hit the beach. Shh, it's him.
You're gonna have to answer it, Rex.
Why can't he put the mail through the door like a normal postman? I mean, Bob, you answer it. I can't stand the bloke.
You should never have engaged him in conversation in the first place. Yeah, very interesting. Wah, wah, wah. Yeah, look, excuse me. Is that letter for us?
Mine. Thank you, postman. Phew. Nice one, Vince.
What does wah, wah, wah mean, anyway?
Open now. Gordon's Garden Centre. When Gordon says his garden centre's open, you just got to believe Gordon. If you're like Gordon and love gardens, you'll love Gordon's Garden Centre. Who's Gordon?
I think he runs that new garden centre. Ooh, a voucher. 10 pence off all sheds. Today only.
Oh, Bob, you've got a perfectly good shed.
Used to have. Last night it was mindlessly thrown into a river by some squirrels.
I suppose 10 pence might not seem a lot, but percentage-wise it represents a substantial saving. And the beach is always open tomorrow.
But I'm covered in coconut oil.
Sandcastles.
A good bargain waits for no one, Wendy.
I want to go to the beach.
Hello, I'm Rex, and we're going to Gordon's Garden Centre.
Beach.
Garden Centre.
Beach.
Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, it's time for a doggy dialogue. Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, a wobbly bobbly dribbly squiggly pond.
Beach.
Garden Centre.
Beach.
Garden Centre.
Beach.
Garden Centre.
Beach.
Beach.
Garden Centre.
Ah!
Gonna go down there.
Well, I suppose we could pick up a new hanging basket.
Can you remember which way we came in?
I'm sure they hide the exits on purpose to make you buy more stuff.
Well, they've got a good selection of plants.
This is the strangest garden centre I've ever seen. Don't you think, Bob? Where's Bob?
Told him not to leave the trolley. Bob? Bob? We'd better split up and look for him. Wendy, you go that way. I'll take Vince and look this way.
Congratulations. You're now in Gordon's shed department. Please feel free to browse at your leisure. We have an extensive range of sheds, starting with the small, the medium, and the magnificent. The most luxurious shed ever built. Nicknamed the iceberg, as 9/10 of it lies below the surface. Why not step inside to try it for size? Oh yes, I can just see you in this cell. Among its many features are dedicated storage spaces for piles of unidentifiable junk, dog biscuits, and bum mags.
Bum mags? Oh, it's beautiful. What about Rex and the others? Oh, is that an angle grinder?
Yes, it comes as standard. Don't worry about your friends now. You've got your shed. You love your shed. You never want to leave your shed.
Oh, I don't know if this is such a good idea.
Of course it is. Look, this is our one chance to get back to where we belong.
Celeriac.
It's all right, don't mention it. Woo! Special offer on both of us at the moment.
No, thank you. We were looking for something more suitable for a loamy soil.
My colleague here is keen on slugs, and I take care of the winged insects. You won't regret it.
No, really.
Hello, little fella. What's your name?
Vince.
Careful, Vince. They're carnivorous plants, you know.
What the...
Hey, put him down this instant.
Back off, dogface, or you're next.
Okay.
Bob, you great big fat jelly wobbly fat bat.
Wendy.
Flipping it, we're trapped in some dystopian nightmare, and you're having a kip in a shed.
Oh, it's a magnificent shed, Wendy. The angle grinder comes as standard.
Help! Help!
Rex.
They got Vince!
We are...
What did he say?
He said we're holding a friend hostage. No harm will come to him. What was that about cardigans? I'm sorry, I can't quite... I said, as long as you take us home with you. Oh, yes, that's right. So, we're holding your friend hostage.
Put the dog down.
Who said that?
A talking bonsai tree.
No, a talking alien plant pot. The bonsai's just for show.
I think it's time we were going.
Oh, please, feel free if you think you can find your way home from hyperspace.
We've been abducted by a pod.
Yeah.
My name is Gordon. I am an alien from the planet Gordon. Everyone on my planet is called Gordon, except John. But we call him Gordon to avoid confusion.
But what do you want with us?
I have been sent to Earth in this spaceship, disguised as an out-of-town garden centre, to round up and capture all the Gordons on the planet. And I think you'll agree, I've done rather well.
But my name's not Gordon. I'm Rex.
And I'm Bob.
My name's Wendy, and this is...
Trousers?
Silence, Trousers! Why do you lie to me, Gordon the Runt? And you, bad Gordon. And as for you, Gordon...
It's true. None of us are called Gordon.
Not even Trousers?
He's called Vince.
Then I have been seriously misled! I will take this up with Gordon, but already you know too much. And for that, you must pay. Gordons? Take them to the chamber and bring our blabbermouth friends as well.
After 4 years' imprisonment on the planet Gordon, Bob managed to bribe a cleaner and we escaped to the furthest reaches of the galaxy, where we learned the skills of the Star People.
Origami!
We enjoyed their way of life for many years, and our plant companions excelled in space combat.
Origami!
And origami. But after a bit, we were captured and imprisoned in the Tower of Khan. This is where we take up the story.
Anyone for a hat?
No!
There is only one way to escape from the Tower of Khan, by hitching a ride on the back of a giant space turtle. We were doomed.
Doomed.
Oi! Over here! All right.
A giant space turtle. Oh yes, very convenient.
Well, this is a surprise.
Home, 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 home.
Thanks for the lift, Chris.
No worries.
Do you want to come in for a cup of tea?
No, should be getting back early before it gets dark.
Let's get some chaffee on. I'm starving.
Well, this is nice. If you like chintz.
Glad we made the effort.
Was this ever fashionable? I feel slightly nauseous. You could rip this whole house down and make a dress.
What's this? Open now, Gordon's Grill. When Gordon says his grill is now open, you just got to believe Gordon. If you like Gordon and love grills, then you love Gordon's Grill.
Gordon's Grill? Now I know we're definitely going to the beach.
Hang on, 10p off all chuffy.
Could be worth a visit.
Damn you, Gordon the Runt!
I will have my revenge.
It's Smith down the wing to Jenkins. Back to Smith. Lovely play there. And Smith must score! He'll be disappointed with that as the half-time whistle blows.
No, no, no. I'll sort it, Wend.
Come on, Bob. Hurry up.
OK. Just a minute.
Oh, fantastic. What?
Oh, great.
Oh, Bob.
What?
Bob, I can't believe you're really... You just...
Ooh. Second half's underway.
And he scores! What an amazing goal! Let's have a look at that again.
Yeah, the big guy's come down the wing. He's gone in hard and he's put in the top left corner. He buried that one. Fantastic.
Race the band, race the band, it's time for a doggy dialogue. Race the band, a wobbly bobbly trilly squiggly dog.
Flipping egg, Bob. That's the third sofa this month.
I'll fix it, I'll fix it.
And you're eating us out of house and home.
I'll go shopping. I'll go now, okay?
That's not the point. I really think you should admit to yourself that you're a big, fat, jelly, wobbly, fat...
This is a body I'm completely at ease with. I am not fat, I'm deliciously plump, all right?
Yeah, and I'm Gwyneth Paltrow.
Look, Bob, you just need to lose a bit of weight. Get fit. We'll help you.
You're wasting your time, Rex. If he's tried one fad diet, he's tried them all. Once a chunky bum, always a chunky bum.
Trousers?
Wendy's right. I've tried to lose weight before. I just can't do it.
Bob, it's not easy, I know, but you've just got to change your diet, change your lifestyle, take regular exercise.
Right, right. Change of diet, change lifestyle, regular exercise. I want my stomach stapled.
That'll be 10 quid.
You have done this operation before?
Not exactly. Now hold still.
You all right, Bob?
Yes. Yes, thank you.
Get to shopping then.
No, no, I'll sort it out.
Whoa! What is that?
Oh, Bob, you idiot. What have you gone and done?
Dr. Dog stapled my stomach for me. Reduces the cravings, you see. All I want to eat now is this grape, and that will satisfy my hunger.
How much did he charge you for that, then? Dr. Dog's a quack. It's as plain as the eye patch on your face.
I know, I know. Ooh.
You big daft.
If I've said it once, change of diet, change of lifestyle, regular exercise.
Okay, okay.
And don't forget to take the tablets. Next! Oh, you again. You're not getting your 10 quid back.
I don't want my money back. I just want some help. I'm desperate. I want to lose weight, not me friends.
Stop it. You're making me shirt all soggy.
I just want to be thin.
Well, there is this. You won't like it.
What is it?
Plastic surgery.
Oh.
Oh, in your case, plasticine surgery. Right. Insert pointy bit A into fleshy bit B.
Ow!
After first administering anaesthetic.
Rex, look at this.
Auntie Brenda solves your canine conundrums. I've got no nose.
No, the other one.
My wife's a bitch.
No, that one. The letter of the month.
Too fat for friends? Dear Auntie Brenda, my friends don't like me anymore because I'm fat.
I claim I'm big boned, but I know I'm not. As they say, I'm just a big, fat, jelly, wobbly, fat dog. Please help me before I do something desperate.
Do you think this is from Bob?
Yours, Bad Bob. The one with the eye patch on the telly.
Ooh, so we've got through to him at last.
Wendy, that's not the point. This is a cry for help. We don't want him to do anything desperate. I blame the media always using greyhounds as models. We must show Bob that we care, that we like him as he is.
Do we?
We do.
Right.
Look, Wendy, look. Remember last summer in Clacton? We were so happy and carefree.
He ate all our ice creams.
But he bought us some more.
He ate them as well.
Okay, but he didn't eat the third lot, did he? Not all of them.
You might have a point, Rex. I suppose he's not a bad size for his breed, whatever that is.
So, how do I look?
Fine.
I've created a monster.
Can I take a look in the mirror?
I don't have any mirrors.
Yes, you do. There's one in the bog.
No mirrors. Anywhere.
I feel really good. Thank you. Here's your 10 quid.
Keep it.
What's that smell?
Fried chuffy for Bob. Show him we think it's okay to be big boned.
Ta-da!
Yes?
It's me.
Nothing today, thank you. Look, we're atheists, we've got double glazing, and we went down to the library last week and memorised the encyclopedia.
But it's me, Bob! Hey, not bad. Not bad at all. Maybe still a bit big around the hips, though. Look what you've done to me. Look what you've done to me. Look what you've done to me.
What the hell have you done to Bob?
He made me do it. He made me do it.
Dr. Dog?
Speaking.
I was wondering if I could come in for another nip and tuck.
No.
Say yes.
Well, come in, I suppose.
I'm on my way.
What's your game?
Scrub up, Nurse Wendy.
Hey, what are you doing here?
It's for the best, Bob.
This isn't what I wanted. I want to be thin.
You'll have to wear this so you don't lick the stitches.
You amateurs.
Twiglets.
You did look ridiculous, Bob.
I suppose so.
Come on, let's go home. You must be hungry.
Yeah, starving.
Do you remember that day at Clacton, Bob?
No, I don't.
Bob, you are a big fat slob. There's always something in your gob. But there's no need to make amends.
We'll always be your friends.
Don't try to exercise. It's really not that wise. Pile on the pounds.
And we'll still want you around.
Bob, you've got the biggest girth. You've been like that since birth. It is written in your genes.
Slims beyond your means.
Your size is XXL, but on that we will not dwell. It'll be your epitaph.
You were a good friend and a half.
Faster than a speeding carrot. Stronger than the strongest weed.
How was it?
Fine, if you like celebrating outmoded, oppressive, patriarchal institutions.
Don't worry, Wend. I'll make an honest woman of you if all else fails.
Thanks, Rex, but I'd rather contract diphtheria. I don't want to get married. I'm just bored.
Feeling bored?
My life's going nowhere.
Life going nowhere?
And I'm consumed by existentialist, nihilistic feelings about the sheer pointlessness of being.
A bit fed up.
Now that's the kind of thing I'd like.
Then why not join the army? It's a good career, it's great fun, and your chances of dying horribly are smaller than you think. The army. Guns and fun.
That's it. I'm going to join the army.
So am I. I'm going to get a bazooka.
Let's all join.
Jam.
Right, laddie, what's your name?
Hello, my name's Rex, and welcome to my world, sir.
What was that? There's no room for wobbly, bobbly, jibbly, squigglyness in this army. Get out!
There's no need to shout.
Okay, miss. Want to be a soldier, does you?
Yep.
Why that then?
Well, recently I've been overwhelmed by feelings of existential angst.
That'll do. Okay, you're in.
Next! Sorry, sir. Says here, applicants must have at least 2 times.
Oh.
So much for equal opportunities.
Got any spare bazookas?
Next! Good physique. Want to join the army?
Rosers.
Right. Can you work out this very odd sum? Brilliant! Welcome to the army of the fit! Right, you horrible lot! Attention! Let me tell you what army life is going to be like. It's going to be hard. Tough. Brutal. You're gonna get really muddy. What do you think about that, eh, lassie?
I hear mud's good for the skin.
Yes, well, that might be true, but you're gonna have to eat worms.
How are we having them?
Raw.
Okay.
And cooked.
Lovely.
With Brussels sprouts.
Great.
Look, it's not like a flipping advert, okay?
To be honest, I didn't really expect it to be.
And I'm really gonna shout at you all a lot.
Come on, Bob. There's more to life than the army, you know.
No, there isn't.
You can't stay in there forever.
Can if I want.
Okay, I'll take these sausages away then.
Sausages? Well, let's not be too hasty, eh?
Last week you didn't even want to be in the army.
Suppose.
Why don't you make something in there, eh? Some project to take your mind off things?
Congratulations on your promotion, sir!
Warning. Warning.
My name is Wendy and I am mean.
Her name is Wendy and she is mean.
Although I'm made of plasticine.
Although she's made of plasticine.
My name is Wendy and I am mean.
Ah, this is more like it, Bob. What are you up to?
Well, you know that broken air dryer we had?
Yes.
Well, ta-da! I've crossed it with a microwave. Dries your hair in seconds. Look! Rex, where'd he go? Well, if you're not interested...
I'm right here, you big chump. What have you done to me?
You seem to be invisible. Is your hair dry?
I don't have any hair, for Pete's sake. None of us do.
Oh, yeah. Phil.
This could be great fun.
Warning. 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 Warning.
Don't do it. We'll all die.
Go on. Press it. You know you want to.
Don't do it. Wait a minute. That's my line. Go on. Press it. Press it. Press it.
Bored and invisible. You'd have thought we'd have had all sorts of adventures. Blimey, Bob. What's that smell?
Sorry.
I can see you.
Oh, well, must be some sort of chemical reaction.
Not bad. Not bad at all. Welcome to the army, soldier. Always knew you could do it.
And you're wearing my costume?
I am not.
You are? This one smells.
Come here and say that.
Make me smelly?
Yes.
Hooray! No, no, wait a minute, you're right. Cobblers. Sorry, everyone.
Now we're war on then. Marvellous timing. Keep that metal shiny.
War? I don't want to go to war. Finch, you little blighter. What have you done? Bad dog. Bad dog. Look at all these nuclear warheads you've launched at France and other places.
Oh, hello.
Keep still, Rex.
What's going on?
Vince has declared war on France.
Open up! We need our top recruit, Private Wendy, back to spearhead our assault on the enemy.
They're not here.
Put the gun down, Rex. I'm going to do my duty and go to war for Queen and country. If I should die, think only this of me, that there is some corner of a...
Flipping heck!
Hello. Yes, they're not here. Come in and...
Hi, Wendy. What the heck?
Gordon, Bennett, Bob, what have you done?
Don't try and stop me, Rex.
Oh, yes.
I'm ready now.
Okay, Private Wendy, you're coming with me.
Yes, result. Will I get my own bazooka?
Yes, yes you will. Right, by the left on that double. Quick
shot!
Oh, I just want to go home.
The war's off. Nobody turned up. Well, they started it. Oh, did we?
Oh, yeah. Oh, right. Yeah. Yeah, sorry, Dad.
Sir,
that's it. I'm not Wendy. I'm Bob.
What? I don't believe it. Private Wendy, you truly are a mistress of the disguise arts.
No, I'm Bob, not Wendy.
How? Well, you've transformed yourself from a fragrant, delicate creature into this flabby, overweight oaf.
I am a flabby, overweight oaf. I'm Bob. I shouldn't be here.
You're right. Someone with your talents belongs in special forces. You'll be perfect for this top undercover mission, Operation Bonkers. Now, you'll commence by swimming up this sewage outlet here, proceeding to the enemy camp, where you will place limpet mines L, A, and R, B.
No!
Clouds.
Oh,
What's that funny object you've made for your science project, Runt?
It's a jetpack, miss. I'm going to be just like Rocket Raymond. Behold the power!
Daddy's
Rex, you cheeky, take it off. I haven't finished it yet. It was supposed to be for your birthday.
Oh, Bob, was it? Cool, thanks. Can I have a little go? I'll be really careful. Is this the start button?
No, take it off. The boosters still need calibrating and do not, I repeat, do not touch that button.
It is the start button, isn't it? Cool. Oh,
look, yes it is, but well, don't touch it because I still haven't fitted the control panel. Typical.
Hello, I'm Rex and welcome to my universe.
What the blinking flipping hell with that?
Rex found that jetpack I've been making for his birthday. Trouble is, he hasn't got the control panel thing.
Will he be all right out there? How's he going to get home?
Oh, he'll come down when it runs out of fuel.
Oh, good. I'm feeling a bit peckish. Fancy a snack?
Certainly do. Have we got any pickled eggs left?
Looks like some kind of bear in a party hat.
Oh, no, not again.
So this tiny little thing controls the jetpack, does it?
Yep. Butter some baps, Wend.
So what happens if I give this bit a twiddle?
That. Well, that turns the thing off. Grubs up.
For 1,000 moons we have waited. The sacred book of Rangoon said it would be so. We are honored by your presence. You are a god.
Oh, thank you very much.
The waiting is over. At last, he is here. Please welcome Rocket Raymond.
Well, that's very flattering, but...
Come, the time is at hand.
You look a lot taller on TV, by the way.
For it is written that Raymond will come and he will rid us of the curse of the Bro Kali. Prepare for combat.
So what exactly does this bit do?
That one, that's your primary ignition. Catch up.
This, sacred book, what exactly does it say?
Look, I've found some pickled eggs.
Right, have we got any bread in there?
Fancy a pickled egg?
Mmm, oh yeah, as long as one over here.
Yeah, yeah, all right, I'm coming. What's the matter with you? Rex, you been drinking?
Do you want half the rest of this cake, Bob?
Bob, I'm trapped! I can't start the engines of the jetpack!
Put a dollop of cream on it, would you? Sorry, Rex, you were saying...
The engines, Bob! How do I start them?
Oh, the engines. Well, you should have said. I can start them from back here. There you go, Rex. Rex? Well, how rude can you get? Ta, that was Rex. Sounds like he's drunk to me.
So, that's it. You guys are aliens. I'm Dan Jansen. Together, we can rule the universe. Are you on?
Yeah!
Hey, hi. Remember me? Rocket Raymond?
My people are unhappy, Raymond. You left us somewhat prematurely. Now you think you can buy our forgiveness with a fish?
Yes. Sorry about that. Where's this Bro Kali then?
No!
Oh,
Raymond, at your service. Well, that's not very flattering, is it? Oh, I see. Another freeloader trading on my reputation. When will you chaps ever learn?
But I...
Raymond, you saved us as the sacred books prophesied you would. We are grateful.
No need to thank me. It's all in a day's work. Look out, Evil. I'm on your tail. Oh, and I'd burn that imposter if I were you.
I'm your biggest fan.
You heard, Raymond. Burn him!
Hello, Bob speaking.
Bob, I'm in trouble. Well, I need your help. I'm about to be burnt at the stake.
Oh, I'm not saying you deserve it, but you did go into my shed without asking.
Please, Bob, I'm sorry. Just fire the jetpack, please. I might die. He's not firing properly. Bob, this is an emergency. Is there anything at all like a backup engine?
Only the backup engine? Is that the sort of thing you mean?
How do I start it? Quick!
All right. Follow my instructions very carefully. Now, open the breastplate, you'll see some wires.
Yes?
There's a green wire, a blue wire, a red wire, and a yellow wire.
Yes!
Right, next to the yellow wire, you should see the primary detonator override. Do you see it?
Hurry, Bob!
Ignore that. That's just for show. What you want is the button marked backup engine stuck on the left shoulder plate. Ah! Spec, we'll see you soon then, eh? Where's your TV guide, Wend?
You've just eaten it, you big fat jelly wobbly. Ah!
What on earth's happening?
You've landed in Vince's dream.
Oh, really? It's not too bad. Vince? Vince, no!
Thank you, Rocket Raymond. Through the use of your jetpack, you really have saved me and my family from the wrath of that angry upholsterer.
Don't thank me, old man. Once he'd got so far, I just knew I had to pull the rug from under his feet. It's curtains for him now.
Ow, careful!
What have you been up to, Rex?
Up to? Nothing much. It's personal. Private.
Terrorist.
Well, I went to see Dr. Dog.
You went to see Dr. Dog?
I had some funny coloured hair growing in a certain area.
Where?
On me back, if you must know. He put me under a general anaesthetic and then he...
Took your flipping ear off.
What? Hello, I'm Rex and... I'm not a complete dog anymore.
Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, it's time for a doggy dialogue. Rex the Runt, a wobbly, bobbly, dribbly, squiggly dog.
Why'd you let him put you under anaesthetic?
Oh, I don't know. I wasn't myself. It can be very traumatic, you know, the sudden discovery of unsightly body hair.
Come here. Oh, for God's sake, Rex. He's a con man. A fly-by-night. A wheeler dealer.
Flipping hell's bells, Rex.
Language, Wendy. Your ear has probably been sold to some rich one-eared person.
Ow! Leave it, Bob.
Probably lost their old one in dubious circumstances.
Dr. Dog's ripped us off that many times. I thought you'd have more sense.
I think we should pay him a little visit. I'll go get the gun. Sorry, Rex. It's all I could find.
Ow, Bob. Careful.
Shh. Brilliant, Bob. Glad to see you prepared. Anyone got a plan? Anything?
I know. What if...
What do you reckon, Bob?
Well, we could...
Try the other ear. Did you just say...
Yes. Yes, I did.
I was going to say we could sue him for medical negligence or something, or we could just go in and ask for your ear back. Is he in? Give us a leg up, Bob.
What do you lot want? Take a close look at my head, Dr. Dog. A medical practitioner of your expertise ought to be able to identify my little deficiency with ease.
Nope.
Give us his ear back.
I ain't got it.
Yes, you have.
I ain't.
Yes, you have. I came to see you earlier and I distinctly remember arriving with two ears.
Can't say I noticed.
And getting home with only one. Now, give it back.
No.
Ah, so you admit you've got it then?
I might have. But I got it fair and square.
Eh?
You signed a disclaimer.
That was when I was coming round from the anaesthetic. I thought you wanted an autograph.
Oh, I didn't know you were such a fan.
Oh, yes, I love you. Look, it's only a little bit of plasticine.
You are talking about my flipping ear, and I want it back. It must be here somewhere.
Get away from him.
Ow! Ooh. Ah. Ow! Ah. What have you got going on here?
Boundaries of science are fading away. Anything is possible. I'm at the cutting edge.
He is, you know.
Eh?
Genetic experiments. Everyone's doing them. Loads of money in it.
It's an expanding market. That's right, Brian.
What are these?
Genetically modified slugs. The result of an experiment to make them taste like chuffy dog food.
Really? Mmm, good.
Yes, the experiment didn't actually work. Mm-hmm. They still taste like slugs.
Hey! My ear! What have you done to it?
That ear is a crucial part of my experiment to develop hearing ears for the blind. For tiny little blind children with no ears and no shoes or toys. Just think, Rex, you might have lost an ear, but thousands of children will be grateful to you forever.
That's rubbish. He was going to clone you.
Yeah, I was going to say that. All right, I was going to clone you.
Why?
Merchandising. Look.
Very impressive.
That's nothing like me. Kiss it here.
It's mine by rights.
I want my ear back.
Ow!
Let go.
Well, that's knackered it.
Oh, Bob.
Sorry, I thought it was a slug.
Look, don't worry. You'll get your ear back.
How?
Because I've isolated the plasticine gene.
So?
Can't you see? I have here the genetic information that makes us what we are. I think it's this one.
And?
Well, if I were to inject Rex with a bit of this, his ear should grow back, I think.
Do you really think I'm so stupid that I'd be an unwitting stooge for your grotesque experiments twice in one day?
Oh, go on, Rex.
Oh, all right then. Ah! Well, my skin feels a little dry. How do I look?
Is there any history of root vegetables in your family?
Huh? Ooh. Ooh. Saints preserve us!
Is this the best you can do?
You've got your ear back, haven't you?
But I'm all hairy.
There's no pleasing some people.
Why, you, I ought to...
Leave it, Rex.
Yeah, Rex. Let's go home and... I'll give you a shave.
You're not giving me a shave.
Well, I'll do it then.
Don't worry, Rex. I'll use that razor designed for sensitive skin.
That's my razor.
You won't use that menthol foam, will you?
Oh, that stuff really stings me armpit.
Phew. Well, viewers, I got away with it again. I thought we were going to have my guts for garters. I cannot believe that... Oh, no, they've left little... I wonder...
Ow! Ow! Bob, watch me nipples. Ow!
Hold still, you big baby. Come here.
Ow!
Oh, that's much better, Rex. Here, let me spoil you with a good splash of this.
Ow!
Pipe down, Rex. Your howling's worse than the racket Vince makes with that guitar.
Where is Vince? First you lose your ear, then we lose Vince. Now let's just get in there, get the little rascal and go.
I think I'm getting a rash.
you know. I don't think those slugs were chaffy flavoured after all.
There he is. Come on, Vince.
Vince.
Come on, Vince.
I prefer this one.
Vince.
Whatever.
Moderate, Fisher, German Bite, North at Zira, South at Zira, Fair Isles.
Well, genetic experiments. Let that be a lesson to us all. Frontier science can be a dangerous thing. We have to be on our guard.
Taxi!
Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, a wobbly bobbly curly squiggly dog. Rex the Runt.
So much procreation then. Marvellous, isn't it? You leave them alone for 5 minutes and this is what happens. Ingrates.
Flippin' heck, listen to this. Dear Wendy, congratulations. You may have won the Nobel Prize for Science. Find out if your amazing discovery, stroke invention, has won at tonight's glamorous award ceremony.
What have you ever discovered, stroke invented, Wendy?
That's just it, Bob. Nothing.
Megaphone?
Yes, thank you, Vince.
Apart from that revolutionary new serum, which will fundamentally alter the modern world as we know it.
A serum?
Psychics.
Award ceremony. 8 till late, dress code scientific yet sexy. No white coats. Bring a bottle. Blimey, I better get my hair done.
Hold up, Wendy. What are you talking about? What revolutionary serum?
Haven't been in the spare room lately, have you? If you must know, it's a truth serum. Simple but brilliantly effective.
Ooh.
But Wendy, how does it work?
Stimulates the retroproteins in your neural cortex, sending a stream of positive neurons to your sensory verbal lobe. Right, I'm off to Alfonso's and don't even think about trying to get in there.
Yes, thank you, Wendy. We have got more important things to do, you know. Hello, I'm Rex, and welcome to my world.
Crick and Watson.
Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, it's time for a doggy dialogue. Rex the Runt.
She's gone.
I'm going in. Cover me.
Ow!
Oh, God.
You stay out here, Vince. Stay. Good boy. Oh. And I thought she only came in here to dance in front of the mirror.
Ooh, careful, Vince.
Electricity.
You little rascal. I told you to stay outside.
Earth.
This must be it.
Yeah, the truth serum.
Shall we?
Well, Wendy, new customer, is it?
Yeah, my sister recommended you.
Did she? Oh, great, yes. That's wonderful.
I brought in this magazine, you see. I want this style. Thought it were very modern in an 80s type of way.
Right. Well, the thing is...
You don't have to be as big and bouncy as that.
Okay, well, the thing is...
And I'd like my tips frosted and all.
And your tips frosted. Right, excuse me. Chelsea, go and wash that lady's hair. Don't forget the conditioner.
Going to a bit of a do, are you?
Yes, I am, thank you for asking, actually. I'm going to the Nobel Prize Bash. I'm up for an award. I've invented a new drug which stimulates the retroproteins in the neural cortex, forces people to tell the truth.
Brilliant. Is that anywhere near our beefa?
Maybe we haven't had enough.
Wait, maybe just a top-up. Yes, that's it. I'm definitely starting to feel really... truthful. It's amazing. I've never been able to say this before, but now I feel I have to. Remember that time last Halloween when we had that party?
Yeah.
And it got really late and everyone was hungry.
Yeah.
And I went out and got chips.
Yeah.
And paid with your money.
Yes, Bob.
Well, I kept the change.
You've...
Oh, yeah, Alfonso. I haven't got all day, you know. Well, what on earth are you doing?
Well, I...
Look, I've just had it washed. Have you forgotten to comb it? You gotta comb it before you start clipping away.
Oh, silly me. Right.
Serum.
And you know I said it was okay because I'd cried at Kramer versus Kramer too.
Yeah, I was glad you said that.
Well, I hadn't. I laughed all the way through. I thought it was a girl's film.
Pass it over. Right.
Et voilà. Okay.
Yes, that's very nice, very nice.
Yes, I mean, yes, it is. In fact, c'est magnifique.
Yeah, very subtle. And I really like how you've shown off my ears.
I don't know why you wear that stupid eye patch. You've got two eyes.
And the whole room was laughing at you dancing to Kraftwerk.
Well, we always thought you were gay.
They all hate you down the red line.
Well, they hate you everywhere else.
At least I get laid once in a while.
You're brown.
You're mauve.
The horror. Plasticine.
There you are, madam. Tips frosty blonde. And a blow dry. Oh, success. Chelsea, can you make some coffee for that lady over there? And bring me, Oh, my word. How clumsy. I am so sorry. How can I apologize?
It's all right. Stop fussing.
Et voilà. The finishing touch, the sherry on the cake.
Yeah, that's great, yeah. Thanks, Alfonso. It's really me.
I love you, Bob.
I love you too, Rex.
Hi, boys.
Oh, hi, Wendy.
Well, what do you reckon?
You've got no hair.
You're bald, Wendy. We don't know why you went to the hairdressers.
You've never had any hair. And your tits are the same size as your eyes.
Sorry, Wendy. I have to tell you, we've drunk your truth serum. It made for a revealing afternoon.
Well, that's interesting, because you've been drinking orange juice. This is the real truth serum. I knew you wouldn't be able to keep your paws off it. Blimey, you're right. I really don't have any hair. My tits are...
Maybe I'll room for one more. Thanks.
Isn't this exciting, Wendy? All the glamour, all the glitz.
The salmon patty was off, and I haven't got any hair.
She's had a bit too much truth serum.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Nobel Prize for Science. And the nominations are... Professor Carl Bontz for his very complicated sum. Wendy for her truth serum. My brother for his invisibility potion. And Mrs. Kylie Mandel-Broschka for the cold fish and powered vacuum cleaner. And the winner is... My brother for his invisibility potion.
That's amazing.
Unfortunately, my brother cannot be here tonight, but he has recorded this message.
It's a fix. Your brother wins every year. There is no invisibility potion, just the smell of corruption. Get your hands off me. Leave me alone.
Oi. You let go of me.
Get off.
Stop it.
And stay out.
Melons.
Well, that's that then. It's back to dancing in front of the mirror for me.
Listen, Dave. I feel like I gotta tell you. You stink.
That's all right, Derek. I've been sleeping with your wife.
Next the runt, next the runt, a wobbly-bobbly, dribbly, squiggly dog. Next the runt, next the runt, a wobbly-bobbly, dribbly, squiggly dog. A wobbly-bobbly, dribbly, squiggly dog.
Passenger announcement, flight BA693 now boarding outside Rex's house.
Well, I'm off then.
What? You're off on holiday, are you?
No, I thought I'd paint the shed dressed as Magnum. You know I'm going on holiday. I've been telling you for weeks.
But what's going to happen about the Rex the Runt special? We were going to do that beast of a Granite Mall thing.
What now? I'm not in that episode, remember? It was specifically written without a part for me, so I could take a well-earned break.
What's this beast thing about, then?
There's a beast. On a moor, near Crannock. And you, Bob and Vince go off to find out what it is. You capture it, tie it up in...
Right. Well, who have you got to play the beast of? Oh, shut up. Who have you got to play this creature?
Do I have to do everything round here? You'll have to hold an audition, won't you?
Last call for passenger Mr. R. Runt for flight BA693 to Playa del Tizos.
Look, I've got to go. Bob, just remember, our audience expects quality.
No problemo.
I said, last call for passenger Mr.
All right, all right, I'm coming.
And ensure that your seatbelts are securely fastened.
Hello, I'm Bob and, welcome to my world!
Strive for the Bad Bob Show! Bad Bob!
Bad Bob! The big one I got that you know!
I think we should have advertised wider than the Rexland Gazette.
Relax. They're all experienced FESPs. A lot of them have done telly before.
None of them really shout beast to me.
Next! Well, Mr. Knitted Thing, your CV looks impressive. Can you tell us a little about yourself? Maybe? Anything? No? Next!
Come by ya, my lord. Come by ya. Come by
ya. Thank you.
Oh, he looks a bit of all right. Nice eyes. Like an eagle.
Well, Mr. Man, I believe you've prepared a soliloquy for us.
Mm-hmm. Flipping heck. Cultured and all.
In your own time, then.
Ooh, that were powerful. What are you looking at me like that for?
Next. Look, sorry, I know chickens are fashionable at the moment, but it's a beast we're looking for, you see. Yes, yes, I realise that. It's just that we can't afford the prosthetics.
I didn't know you spoke chicken.
Sorry, we don't accept bribes. Next. Next.
But I haven't done anything yet.
Sorry, but I don't think you're quite right, Wayne.
Why not?
Well, you're a zebra. You don't get many zebras in animation.
Oh, why is that then?
Well, you're incredibly hard to animate. Look. 1. Headaches. 2. Steam. 3. Ectoplasm. 4. Zebras. 5. Skipping. See, you're in the top 5.
It's those stripes. You'll make people's eyes go funny.
We need somebody with a bit of facial expression. You know, like this.
Oh, heck, I can do that.
I'm sorry.
But I could be a great role model for zebras. Everywhere.
Next, please.
Come on, let's give him a chance.
Next!
He's the last. There isn't anyone else.
Welcome on board, Wayne.
Thanks, Bobby.
It's Bob.
Ooh, get off me, you scabby little git. Ooh, I'll probably get warts now.
Trousers.
Who am I playing again?
The Beast of...
Oh, yes, the Beast of Crannock Moor. Yes, I've played him before, summer season, Brighton, 1973.
Please, Miss Wendy and Mr. Bob, Mr. Vince,
You've got to find out what's been a-worrying my sheep.
Yes, we will.
I've heard it said...
Beast, I've heard it said that a beast.
Oh, I've heard it said... I've heard it said that a... Nah, it's gone again. Thanks, Vince. There is a beast on the moor. There has been many...
A sighting. And they say tis a terrible...
And they say tis a terrible thing.
Arr.
Goblin.
I thought you were supposed to be Scottish.
Look, footprints. Come, Wendy, Vince. Let us follow them.
Goodbye, then, my friends. Arr.
Blimey, Wend. These footprints are enormous.
Shh. Oh, I think I can hear breathing. I thought he didn't appear till Act Two.
All right, everybody, how are you diddling? I'm the Beast of Cranmore Moor, how do you do? My job's to scare the daylights out of you. Oh, yes, it is. I wait in the bushes and I quietly bide my time. Then I'll scare your pants off and you'll sing this little rhyme. How do, missus?
He's the Beast of Cranick Moor, this much is true.
That is true, it's true.
It's like the zebra, everybody.
It's not exactly what we had in mind. I mean, it's a bit old-fashioned.
Oh, yeah, you want them a bit more...
Listen, all your hustlers and all your G's, I got some fresh new beats and I'm
That's
ready to
much
ski.
Better.
Lock up your windows, lock up your doors. I'm the funky fresh beast of Cranick Moor. I'm an old school monster from a...
You're actually quite scary.
Me coming, you just have to...
It's a monster, a real beast. Oh, run for your life.
Rex?
What's happening?
What page are we on now?
Hey, just kidding. I mean, I knew him all along. I had you going, didn't I?
Did you have a good holiday, Rex? You look ever so... Actually, you look terrible.
Get me down from here.
Whoops.
I just overdid it a bit.
Home.
I'm me sunburn, Vince. So, everything all right? Show go well?
Absolutely. A real belter. They loved it.
Oh, hello, Wayne. Long time no see. Scarborough, wasn't it?
That's right. Hello, Reg. How are you diddling?
I'm diddling just fine, thank you.
Can I have me check, please, Bobby? And the rabbit food, as we agreed.
The name's Bob. Bob, all right?
Oi, you! Get off me rabbits! They're expensive, you know.
I don't know. I go away for a few days thinking I can leave you in charge, and what do I find?
I know.
It's supposed to be a supernatural drama.
I gave it my best shot, Rex.
In the tradition of Edgar Allan Poe.
Who's he?
A blood-curdling thriller.
Oh.
Starring a rapping zebra?
I'm so sorry. I've let you down.
Right. Don't worry, Bob. It's okay. Calm down. Stop that, Bob. You're making me knees all soggy. I'm sure it was fine, really.
Thanks, Rex.
Ow! You did your best. And that's what matters most.
No.
I'll tell you this, that has been my ambition all of a career to do that type of a laugh.
No.
Well done, Abigail. Next week you might even be able to get the beans and the toast on the same plate. Ah, Rex, what kind of a gastronomic delight lives in a platter like this? Let's look at the evidence. Rex has made it, and it smells like a dank swamp. It must be that wretched spag ball.
Try a slice.
Why not take it home? Give your friends the chance to sample its unique texture.
Well, I think we've both learnt something about the culinary arts today, haven't we, Lloyd?
If you say so, you spawn of Satan.
Hey?
Cheeky.
Hello, I'm Lloyd, and welcome to my evening class. Excuse me.
It's time for a doggy dialogue. Rex the Runt, a wobbly, bobbly, trilly, squiggly dog.
So, it's a film. Second word, Texas. Third word is...
Bob, give me a hand shifting this lot. Rex will be here any minute. I don't know where we're going to hide his latest creation.
Can't we put it in here with the rest? Oh, maybe not.
I'm home. I hope you're feeling hungry because dinner is served.
Great, thanks. Yeah.
Well, go on. Tuck in. Right. I'm off to do something important. A major career change.
Chips all round.
Chips and egg.
150 notes. Can't say fairer than that. I'm robbing myself.
10 quid.
Call me mad, call me crazy. I'll let you have it for 50.
10 quid.
It's a once-in-a-lifetime offer. Yours for 25, nigga.
10 quid.
All right, then.
Will you take a check?
Need any bins emptying?
Oh, Arthur, love, I've just been for chips. Do you want some of mine?
No, thank you, Miss Wendy. I'll just help myself to a big gherkin.
Oh, you are awful.
I wouldn't do that if I were you. Rex has been doing this cookery evening class,
you Bob, see. Sir, you forget I am a professional waste disposal operative. Stand aside.
See what I mean? Please, Arthur, can you get rid of them for us?
Let's not be hasty. I do believe you've got some marvellous modern art sculpture pieces here. The art establishment are crying out for contemporary works made out of perishables. Mind if I show one of these to a friend of mine?
Who's that, then?
Valerie Boner, the gallery owner. Sells art on the High Street.
Sure, I suppose. Trendy, eh?
Today a van, tomorrow the world.
Burger, please.
Sorry, young fella, me lad. No burgers. That's the menu.
Haven't got any burgers, then?
No, I haven't got any burgers. Riff-raff.
Well, Arthur, you were right. This is important. It has a latent post-futurism about it. Very modern, urbane, sexy.
Just as you said, Bob, Vanessa Parr.
Oh, yes. Sexy. Urban.
Bob is finally attuned to the zeitgeist of the 21st century.
Simply stunning. I will launch you in my forward-looking new show tonight.
You're gonna be rich and famous.
But not as rich and famous as me.
I'll have to tell Rex. Rex? It's your van, then? You're not selling food, are you? Food you've cooked?
Yes. Yes, I am, actually. What do you say to a liver mousse? Very fluffy.
You got any burgers?
This is the menu. Look. This is a cordon bleu van. You couldn't even spell cordon bleu.
No, you're right, I couldn't. I've got something to tell you.
I've seen a gap in the market. High-class cuisine served out the back of a van. Where are you going in your fancy suit, anyway?
Gallery opening. The thing is,
oh,
Rex...
thanks for inviting me. You'll be sorry when I'm rich and famous. Now move along if you're not buying anything.
Well, I tried.
Cotton chips, please.
Look, mate, I consider cookery a genuine heart form.
Bourgeois rubbish. Come with the revolution, you'll be first against the wall, brother. I'm telling that for sure now.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first viewing of what I believe to be three new and exciting artists. Tony Afro, with his revolving concrete pants. Millie Longhorn, who has spelled the word stop using awful. And finally, Bad Bob with his dynamic food totems. Enjoy.
What happens now?
We wait for the critics. If they like your work, you are made for life.
Texture
is beautiful and so provocative. It is food, yet it is art. It is a painting, yet it is a pie. Oh, blimey, sheer genius. Genius, you hear that? I'm a genius. I mean, Bob, you're a genius.
Yeah, brilliant, Valerie. Got any food? You'd think they'd have some things on sticks at least.
Well done, mate. Couldn't have happened to a nicer bloke.
I'm starving, Arthur. Where's the buffet?
Mr. Bad, or may I call you Bob? This is inspired. I have been looking at art for over 20 years.
Well,
Well, who in the name of all that is holy has allowed you to open a fast food outlet?
Thanks, Lloyd. I always knew you had faith in me. I love you.
Food. I must have food. I'm going to faint. I know it. My thumbs have gone numb.
Botticelli.
Look, I just have to eat. There's only one thing for it. Gangway!
Yeah, quite a character, eh?
What's that ghastly smell? These look familiar.
Rex, give us anything you've got.
Oh, yes, Bob. I knew you'd come crawling back. You're just like the rest of them. Chips, kebab, minced cow in a bun, that's all anyone wants. Oi, that's 57p you owe me. Come here. Oh, la-di-da. Oi, what's going on?
I'm sorry, sir. The exit's over there.
These are mine. I made these.
Yes, Valerie, I can vouch for him.
See?
He has all the culinary expertise of a small sponge.
Yeah. And he can't cook either.
How could you? Right, I think these could do with a bit of remodelling.
Rex, that was really uncalled for.
Oh, quite right, Arthur. This is new. This is important.
I've created a monster.
Magnificent. Pollocks.
How contemporary. How much?
They're a dead cert for the Turner.
By heck, Vince, who would have thought that we'd be living with famous artists, eh?
Trousers!
Look at them. You should call yourselves Giblet and Gorge. Garrett, I said you should have called
yourself... All right, Wendy. Thank you. Take no notice, Bob.
Bad news, I'm afraid. I've just spoken to Mr. Boner, and it seems sculpture of the comestible variety is passé.
Eh?
Your has-beens. You're going to have to come up with something radical or you're out.
Right, right. I get the picture.
Think.
Submarines.
Rubber tyres.
A submarine made out of rubber tyres.
Been done.
Can't have been.
A bath full of...
soap.
A bath made out of soap.
Done.
Oh, jelly.
Life-size Val Dunica made out of jelly.
Witty, but thick.
Jam.
Oh, shut it, Vince.
Chips.
Vince.
Shut it.
Apparently, taxidermy is the next big thing.
I'll hold him down. You get the horsehair.
Rex the Runt, a wobbly, bobbly, dribbly, squiggly dog. Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, a wobbly, bobbly, dribbly, squiggly dog. A wobbly, bobbly, dribbly, squiggly dog.
Listen, Bobby, I was down at the beach that night. I saw Wally drown. And get this, it wasn't Hector driving the ute, it was Ricky Sullivan.
Humdrum.
What? I'm just popping out for a bit.
It's not a very nice evening. Where are you off to?
Just gonna stretch my legs. Maybe not even that. I might just sit down. Stand. Near the alley.
What's that you've got with you?
Well, this? This bag? Nothing. It's just a bag. My bag. See you then.
Hello, I'm Rex, and welcome to my troubled world.
Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, it's time for a doggy dialogue. Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, a wobbly, bobbly, dribbly, squiggly dog.
This must be the guy, right on time.
Looks like a phony to me.
Shut it, Doc. I call the shots round here. What are you,
hey
some
man,
kind of freak?
No
put
guns.
The piece away!
Sorry. Oh, you think you got what it takes to be a slipper?
You know why we're called the slippers, man?
No.
Cause we got soul! Terry thought of it. So what's your name, big guy?
Bob.
Is that it?
It's short for Robert.
Well, listen up, Robert. I'm the ace. This here is Terry.
Ow!
And we call this guy the Doctor.
Why are you called the Doctor?
Because I am a doctor.
Enough coffee table talk. This isn't a ladies' meeting, man. Now listen up and listen good. You want to be in the slippers? You got to pass the initiation test. Think you can handle it?
Yeah, I do.
Then get in the pipe. It's getting a bit chilly out here.
Why do you call this the pipe?
Because it's smoking.
Derry, he thought of it.
Let's hit it!
And that concludes tonight's documentary on Echo and the Bunnymen.
Fascinating. Right, I'm off to bed.
I am going to wait up for a bit, Wind.
Oh, Bob's just going through a stage. Attention-seeking. If we ignore him, he'll stop it.
He's just not himself, though, is he? Arthur saw him in the woods last week
and said, I seen him hit a tree with a plank and shout at a little baby squirrel.
Maybe he thinks we're boring or something.
Why would he think that? We're his oldest friend. Fancy a cocoa?
Yeah. I just hope he hasn't got mixed up in things he shouldn't have.
That's it. Left hand down a bit. Left hand down. Not too much. That's better.
Why are we driving everywhere in reverse?
Because society wants you to drive forwards, man. It's a trap.
And now for all you night owls, it's the second chance to catch Squirrel Castle. And Michael has an important meeting.
Don't you just love it, man? Death and God, side by side.
What, exactly are we doing here?
It's initiation time, Robert. Still wanna be a slipper?
Yeah.
Good, because you got just 2 minutes to sketch the church. And no rubbing out.
Think you can handle it, farm boy?
With shading?
Bob.
Time up, man. Put the pencil down.
Let's take a look. Not bad, Robin. Not bad at all. Some of these tombs are really in perspective.
You did all right, man. The ace is a stickler for detail.
Is he in?
Is cheese round? Of course he's in. Why, I think Robert here has all the makings of a great slipper.
Brilliant.
Now let's scat. The people who live near the church don't want to hear us hoods drawing all night. Terry, see me out.
Okay, right a bit. To me! Keep it coming!
Okay, we'll pick you up tomorrow 6 p.m. sharp. And listen, you're gonna have to ditch your old breadhead name. You're not Robert anymore. You're not Bob anymore. You're Barry.
Right, Barry.
Now, what was life really like in the 1970s? Time to find out in the Dennis Healy years.
Oh, I've been looking forward to this.
Barry, come out to play, yay.
Bob, what on earth's going on?
Don't know nothing about no Bob, but Barry here's going out.
Bob! Barry, do you have to join a gang?
Can't you just befriend a kestrel?
You just don't understand. I'm a loner, an outsider, and not you or anyone else is gonna make me take a 9-to-5 packed like a sardine in a tin full of bowler hats. Now, if you'll excuse me, I don't much like the company of strangers.
Bob!
Leave me alone! You're tearing me apart!
Good to see you, Barry. Hope you're feeling bad, because tonight's the big night.
You mean?
That's right.
Woo-hoo!
Brilliant!
What time's that program about ships on?
Terry! Now you're a slipper, you gotta pour beans on the steps of the widow's house.
Please. Widow's house.
You think you're up to it?
Uh-huh.
Come on, man. Get out of there.
I don't like this one bit.
Oh, beans. I think I'll just maybe have a couple of beans. All right, lads, settle down. Wonder if you can help me. I have reports of someone round here pouring beans on a widow's step. Know anything about it?
Yeah, it was him!
What? Friend of yours, is he?
No, man. I've never seen the guy before in my life.
We're just taking some cakes to our grandma.
All right, come on, you. Let's get you down the station. But I don't know what the world's coming to.
Uncle.
A husband dies and you tease her with beans. But your mum and dad know you're out?
But...
Well, you went a bit far this time. And you're very lucky, Bob, that the widow didn't want to press charges. What were you thinking of?
Hey, Bob, what's up?
Ignore them, Bob. They're nothing but trouble. We're your real friends.
Listen, we gotta sort this out. I did some thinking while I was in the can. Rex, Wendy, I know I've been acting weird lately, and I suppose you could say I've done some silly things. And you coming here to bail me out today has made me realise who my real friends are. The punks!
Bob, you don't know what you're saying. They're the reason you were thrown in the clink.
She's right, Bob. That's why we're here.
Yeah, there's been a bit of a change of plan.
Ace? Doc?
Call me Brian, Bob. Look, it's been great hanging around with you for the last couple of days, but, well, it's all got a bit out of hand, and anyway, we've got to get back to our proper jobs.
Proper jobs? Terry, tell me this isn't true.
I'm afraid it is. I'm an estate agent. Brian here works at the airport.
And that bloke sells jeans at rip-off prices in the mall.
But what about the slippers? What about the pipe?
Oh, we got rid of that old banger. Anyway, must go. Ciao.
Bye, Bob.
But we had plans. We sketched the church. I even borrowed some of Wendy's earrings.
If they're the ones with the feathers in, you can keep them.
I don't understand!
Come on, Vince. Let's go home. I'll explain it to you one day.
Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, a wobbly-bobbly to this wiggly dog. Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, a wobbly-bobbly to this wiggly dog. A wobbly-bobbly to this wiggly dog.
Oh, turn it down up there.
The time had come to clear out Bob's shed.
Come on, Bob, it'll be a wonderful cleansing experience.
That's right. Feng Shui can't be very balanced in there.
I know. But it's very difficult, Wendy. It's like throwing away old friends.
It's a load of old junk, Bob.
Junk it may be, but quality junk. Worth a few bob to me, cheeky cockney sparrow wheeler dealer that I am.
It's Arthur Duskart, everybody, again.
Who, Miss Wendy, you sure do look mighty fine with your scarf knotted in that provocative fashion.
Oh, give over.
My pleasure.
When you're ready.
A three-legged chair, soft nuclear warhead, crystal cut decanter matching glasses, stuffed tapir. Rotisserie.
Hang on, whoa, stop, Kurt, stop the music. What is this?
Oh, it was an idea for a lawnmower based on the principle of the hovercraft.
Sounds oddly familiar.
Too right, my son. If Bob had patented this clever device when he made it, he'd be a rich dog right now.
I did paint it.
But you didn't patent it.
I did paint it. Look, it's green.
No, I said patented it, green. That's nice, actually.
Huh? Now, don't switch it on, Rex. It's not working properly. The propeller was upside down.
Blimey. Hello, I'm Rex, and welcome to my garden.
With a big hole in it.
Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, it's time for a doggy dialogue. Rex the Runt, Rex the Runt, a wobbly bobbly drilly squiggly dog.
All I'm saying is this was your big idea.
Well, give it time.
Look, a customer.
Excuse me, is this Ayres Rock?
No, this is Ayres Other Rock.
Thank you. This one's easier to climb, less dangerous.
Wait a minute, what's that?
Oh, I wonder what's down there.
Ooh! Shut up! I'm telling you, mate, this could be just what we're looking for.
Well, Rex, you've gone and lost me some pretty valuable scrap just then. And you've made a big hole, ruining the charm of your otherwise picturesque garden. And as a council employee, I can tell you that you need planning permission to do things
yes,
like that.
Yes, thank you, Arthur. You lot going to help me fill this in, then?
You did it.
All right. It's my fault. Are you going to help me or what?
No.
Here's Hull. Only $10.
Come back! Right, you.
Come here and point like a man.
Sounds to me like you've upset someone, Rex.
There's someone down there. Oi, you! This is private property. I've got a friend at the council, you know.
Elf!
Oi, that wasn't very funny. I think you should apologise.
You apologise.
No, you apologise.
No, you apologise.
He keeps repeating what I say.
Maybe it's just an echo.
An echo? Don't be silly. Are you an echo?
Am I a gecko? No, I'm a dingo.
No, he wants to play bingo. We haven't got time for games. You apologise at once.
He called you a punce.
Right, you asked for it. You apologise.
No, you!
You!
This went on for some time.
No, you!
You!
Quite some time.
You!
Good luck, mate. Any biscuits left?
They're by the teapot pudding. See you then, Rex.
Can you feed me some more, Ro?
Good idea, Rex. I'm feeling a bit peckish myself.
You better take this.
Call me a ponce, will he?
Oh, it was horrible. It did a horrible scream and then started to hit me.
Look what they've done to my miner's helmet.
I've never seen the like. It had a silver head and one central eye. Right, take that, you swine. And that. And that. And that. And that. And that. And that.
Now look what you've done.
Where's Vince?
I reckon it was an alien. And that is its spaceship. It's one of them!
Bob, what have you done?
Well, that's probably the last we'll see of the little fella.
I didn't mean to chuck him down there. It was an accident.
What? Gravity? What is going on?
Look, I don't think it's a good idea to capture it, Marv.
Nonsense. It'll be just what we need to pull the punters in.
La 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 la.
Go on, you big lummox. Go and get Vince.
All right, I'm going. I've just finished this pasty.
And don't come back till you've found him.
Do you come in peace?
Where are you from?
Trousers.
Trousers? Where exactly is Trousers?
Bye-bye.
Eh? Bye. Will you be visiting again? Bob!
Marvin!
Haven't seen you for ages. How the devil are you?
Fine. You look well.
You too, Bob. Put on a few pounds, eh?
You cheeky little... you haven't seen a little toothy friend of mine, have you?
What? You don't mean...
Bye!
Beats! No! Excuse me, Marvin. I better catch up with the little devil.
Oi, mira ya, Vince da.
Ore da fan nan da yo ne.
Trousers.
Vince. Ah, ureshii. Vince, sign kudasai.
Ah, ichibanme Vince sign kudasai.
Oh.
Oi, Bob, I said that. Bob, I said that. Yanni, or Bob, and I'm
cold.
You shouldn't blame yourself, Rex.
Well, if I hadn't switched on that stupid machine, none of this would have happened.
Do you think he's dead then?
Yeah. They're gone. Forever.
Can me and me brother move in then?
Hey, we're back!
Hooray!
Oh, for goodness sake, I only vacuumed yesterday.
Sushi!
This went on for some time.